Hey guys, I am doing a I am working on a new piece. I am just trying to share this to my my page so that I can have this go to Danza Productions. Bang, bang, bang. Okay. All right. So I'm going to get started. This is kind of cool because I had actually gotten ready to start doing this, and I figured, you know, I'd made a post about it and why build up the anticipation. I actually, I'm going to forgo using actually the watercolor. I'm just going to use the watercolor pencil. Now I'm curious to see how it reacts here. It's kind of neat. I put some of that. Now I'm curious because I put some blue here too. Against that nose, but this is really where I hit it. I've already hit this with some watercolor. Ooh, that's really nice. That's a really nice, I don't know, turquoise. What is it? Copenhagen. That's a color. I like Copenhagen. But now I want to get pretty distinct with this orange. I am trying to keep this here. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I need to get some paper towels, and I'm going to have a little tape to tape this down, right? Give myself some room. And this way I won't move it when I am working on it, which is, you know, beneficial. I would usually tape the whole thing around, but I don't want to get that fucking diverse into it. So anyhow, these are what I'm using. I should probably keep these over here. I have the reoccurring shit. I have the pencil. All right. So you always have to have napkins. So I'm just trying to use two brushes here, and you can probably see here I have with some leftover coffee, and part of the process of doing this, and this is something I want to build up some color on here, so. So I'm gonna do a layer. It's sort of like, if you look at it like shellacking, but you don't wanna shellac all of it, otherwise you can't show any variation in tone or color or whatever, you know? And so, you know, what you do is you don't do all of it, that's a trick, and then you know, I'm really not doing full watercolor with the coffee. I'm doing something that gives it sort of a quality. It gives it a quality. Like, I think, you know, gel medium is something that I know a lot of people use. Now, here's the other interesting thing is using the coffee as the liquid for the watercolor pencils. You know? Kind of looks cool. So over here, I need to do some more. And isn't that pretty cool? Got it in a solo cup. Yeah, and it's kind of satisfying to hit these spots up. Now, what you do is the first thing you do is you want to hit what you want to be the darkest first, And then it started, just comes on like just like a little bit, you know. This, you know, it's like, okay, well, you gotta let something, you know, you can't go all in. But then I do a cheat, which I can basically, I do this so that I can do more layers and it'll dry faster. But it ends up having its own quality. And fine, all right, I have my hair dryer set up. I do have the AC unit on because it's just too damn hot. But this is what you do. This is what we're doing here. Now, this is a trick. This is cheating. But it works. I really like that blue against his face. I think I don't want to do too much coffee on there because I haven't done any real pencil. I left it blank on purpose. I have a lot of other stuff here. I need to consolidate. I was getting inspiration. And here's a couple. Here's one that I really like. This is one that I'd done recently. And there's another one. Couple others. That's a cool one too. So anyhow, just trying to clean up a little bit. I did an awful meow picture, but there you go. There is a first of many cat drawings. This was a quick one. I'm trying to get better. It's hopefully soon to be. All right. Oh, and I also gave you my plans for my content. So, all right. So I want to like get back into this colored pencil shit too. You know, while even though it's, you know, it's not as wet, it's still, you know, drying, and I want to see how dark this got, how fast that got, how darkly fast that got. It's a tricky thing, and sometimes, you know, I want this dude's sideburns to be epic, and what I am doing is I'm just adding just a little bit of something, because this color, this is like sort of a cream colored who's he, what's it, a piece of paper, and it has like a texture to it, which is really nice when you're doing watercolor. You know, I'm still sort of trying to decide, but I really love how that shark, whatever it is, that thing, Copenhagen, came in. So now what I think this needs are some I have the orange out too. I want that. And then, oops, sorry. Then there's these. Wow, there's so many that I can use here. Like, this is something I want to do for this dude's. So let's see what this does. So I have the smaller brush I think I'm going to dedicate to. This, now that's a really interesting color that ended up coming out there, right? So goes on one color and then it kind of actually ends up brightening up the page for some reason, right? And it's just that color, you know. And I don't want to overdo the coffee because, well, I don't want to dip the coffee in there, but it's like to get something that's a nice little undertone there without going too hog wild here. And I want to keep that, like, that thing in there too because, I've got to keep track of the ones that I'm using. So I also want to bring back a little of this. All right. Because you need a little something in the back. That's cool to draw in there. I'm not sure how cool I am with that red, like so red there. So I'm going to try to save it by doing that. And I kind of wetten it out. And it's like, it's more like, okay, it's there, but it's not. It's still there. Let's be honest, but it's not as noticeable. I usually add a bunch in an area so that it ends up looking all right. So that's kind of neat. Let's see. How's that work? That dude's little thing. Oh, that's cool to add a little of that red into there. Where though, this thing is so fucking noisy. Okay, so I want to do a little bit underneath here. Oh, okay, hold on a second. I realize that I have moved this from its situational spot here. Actually, that helps me a lot because now I have more room and more light, so to speak. All right. So, I mean, this is really coming along, you know, and I'll tell you, with this, see, that's kind of nice. Those little accidental splashes definitely add to the character of the thing. So, it's gotta be a little different here and there. This I want to that again. Yeah, I think that's gonna be decidedly darker. Yeah, so I think like part of it is I want to have this coffee element throughout the entire piece. I'm not sure if I want to have it. I don't know. It's pretty well integrated now. I want to be selective though about where I put it, because I think that's good. Sometimes it just falls into place. You know what I mean? And I mean, even though I know Starbucks coffee is fucking expensive, you know, and then you see you have this like little watercolor quality to it. So I think I'm gonna hit this, I'm gonna hit that. I'm gonna hit this for sure. So I need that to be different. So there's some red there. It'll even out here, but I definitely wanna hit that a little bit darker there. Yeah, I don't know. I gotta feel like that's gotta be it. And sometimes it's just like, all right, well, I gotta dab up a little bit. Dab up. You know, sometimes it's about the dabbing, you know? The dabs there. And, you know, I'm using coffee that I drank. So, if you can see, as it's drying, it has, like, this... I don't know if you can see it on your phone or whatever, but there is this, like crystalline effect that it gets. Even when it's dry. You know, it sort of, like, almost crusts on there. Like this forced drying effect, it's like, you know, and I'm like, all right, well, all right, so that's probably annoying if you're listening, probably not listening, but. If you are, we are done with that. Oh, okay. So, whoops. Hair. Okay. You know, sometimes it's just making sure your lines... Like, I guess what I'm doing right now in my current style, this is obviously one of my current drawings. I have previously been, and you've probably seen from some of my work that I've been posting, which is coincidentally fairly old in comparison to you know what I have going here, which is I think very derivative of an inspired moment. But also, you know, with a very strong sense of editing back. That's something that I think it's because it's pencil, you know, it can be erased, it can be altered, you know, after the fact. It offers a lot of opportunity to go back in and say, okay, well, let me discover, because like, see these lines in here, these lines are really nice, but, you know, they, you know, with this just getting rustled around, you know, it gets, but, you know, like, every time you go over it, it has, like, another, you know, another layer. It's, like, super delicate in there, and I actually, if I really wanted to get in there, I would take my glasses off and, you know, go deep into the mix, but, you know, what I'm doing here is, especially with this guy's hair is like half of his deal, you know, and then, well, then his face is pretty much a third. I don't know, man, his deal is super comic-y, which I like, you know, has this like real, you know, older comic style feeling, which I kind of admire. You know, and then you see like the character of line. It's like you're not so much worried about, well, what am I gonna do? You're just saying, all right, well, I know how to execute, but now I'm gonna have fun. I'm gonna bring some energy back into the drawing, which is like definitely got much more, you know, structure. But when I darken in lines and I give it like a little bit more, you know, you're like, oh wow, well, that you may not recognize that being so so clear when you're seeing it, but then it's sort of something that you're just like, all right, well, that's the effect it has, and you see like that variation in line right there. If you can see it, like the last one, I spent a lot of time going in and erasing lines and making sure lines were in the right places. And the thing that's interesting about this is, though, once you end up putting on the wash, so to speak, you can't, erase what's underneath that, because you've really set it into the paper at that point. You'd really have to just paint over top of it. But I'm really pleased with the sensitivity of this drawing. Because typically I'm one of those people that's like doesn't have the patience to say, man, I really want the immediate effect of getting this done. And I'm sort of now of the opinion that it's okay to take a little bit of time, even if it's not like the main work. Who knows if I'll sell this, if I'll do it. I've actually spent, quite a bit of hours on it. But to be truthful is that I'm really taking away the exploration of my feeling, because like as I'm exploring this, you are exploring this as well. I'm gonna see if I can, get this out here. Did it work? Oh yeah, okay. That would be really awesome. All right, so I just gotta bring back some of that, but not as much as that. I'm trying to do this here. So, like, that's so dark. Like, I'm just trying to shape this, because sometimes it's sort of the desired effect is, you see, like how it doesn't fill in all of the. I mean, you want a little white in there, maybe, just to, to give it something. But, like, this is a, like, I'm thinking maybe this is, like, a brown eyes. With a little thing here. I don't know. Maybe it's just, like, fucking there. Okay, then you got this. Make that a little more prominent. So this thing, I'm thinking I can do a little more, and in a way it's more of a coloring than it is of a, cause see, this is like something I was trying to get into with the reds, and I think perhaps with the colored pencils, it'll be a little easier to maneuver. So I want to try to shift over to another color, like, oh, the greens, that's the other thing. I wanted a gray. I'm really fond of this darker green. Let me look at the name of it, what they call it. Vert olive. Oh, vert olive. It reminds me of a certain other kind of olive. Okay, I want this deep brown, and man, this bright blue. And because I'll tell you what, I'm looking at this bright blue. Look at that, right? For bright blue to bring back some of the brightness in there. Isn't that awesome? And I'm thinking that maybe in here, this might be a nice place to put some blue to kind of carry it through. Cause to, I'm trying to think about this stuff, and I'm thinking that I want this to be a bit more on the green side. So, even though this is a, dark. I hate when I go right to the edge of the page, because then it's like, well, you have nowhere to go, and I usually tape this stuff off, but I like giving the green, a little bit of a green to that, to give it a little something, that's what that is. I think, though, I want to give more brown in here. So even though even though the graphite's good, you see how much of a nice edge I get right there. Right there, and I'm like, damn, okay. Wow, that looks really good. That looks really good, guys. Look at that. Look at that, hit all of the lines that I want. Yeah. I mean, this chipper young lad is definitely having some darker brown in there. I'm afraid that this might be the pencil that I get the most use out of, because I really do love this this color, whatever the brown is. Is this a deeper brown? Is this a darker brown? Does this go darker? Ooh, it does. It goes very nicely with the, okay. So with the sideburn, people are like, well, what are these? I think this is an ear overgrowth that it's just like, because it's not like any of the rest of the hair, right? Oh, yes. So there we are. This even too. I like this better than the black. Is this black? It is black. That's why I'm like, wow, it's really good. Why is it so good? Because it's really black. And this is really dark umber. Man, I wish I could have afforded to go get all of the things. Now, this is Verge. I like Verge. Verge is cool. But I want to get more yellow. Because this is also like going on. Yeah, color is interesting for me, because like I know what I know about color, but I also know that, you know, you gotta explore. Actually hit that. Ooh, nice. Oh, nice. Hot shots part two. Nice. Okay. It's not like a correction pen, it's more like a style. Ooh, that is kind of cool though. And then it gets dark in there. This is dark umber. Yeah. Because I'm thinking, if I end up bringing these greens in there, these greens and then these yellows, right? Because I think that I mean, I could be wrong. I could go blue in that as well. But there's something interesting about the green, you know. What is that? I'm not feeling the green on this, I think. I think the green's good here. Would I do a blue or brown? I kind of said this was brown, so I think I should stick to the deal. Maybe it's this kind of a green that gets going on. Because this is cool like this, right? But then... like this might go here, right? I'm not upset about the green being in there. It just sort of is. kind of like the green, very strong green. Very cool. You know, the one thing I've been accused of is going too strong. Well, I've accused myself of. What I am doing in this side of the drawing is I've neglected. Like, you can't build up. Well, I don't want to say you can or you can't. I think that it's purely up to the person, but that being said, I think, you know, when you build up something, you don't want to build up one side more than the other, even though you're trying to both get there. It's not like you're building a jigsaw puzzle. One thing has to respond to the other. You know, if something gets too dark on one side, but not enough, this isn't dark umber, good, okay. So I have this really crazy green over here, which I kind of like. It's his, like, you know, it's the green. There. You know? And you're like, dude, that's a lot of intense color. Yes, it is. But one of the things to remember is not everything needs to stay on the paper. There is a residue of the process, which I am a fan of. Oh, shit. Alright, sorry, I had to adjust my situation. I the thing is that when I do color, I'm usually like saying, all right, well, I'm gonna do. So yeah, now I'm just doing lines, but what I need to do is get a little more courageous here and say, all right, well, this is. Yeah, I'm still doing lines, but brown lines. And they're much darker. Okay, so the always unknown quotient is the coffee. How does the coffee affect the situation? That's kind of interesting, right? And this. I feel like the yellow is a bit dramatic, but that green tone kind of goes nicely there. The blue tone stuff, I don't know, I guess I had a little bit of a fear of going too heavy on the blues too soon, you know? Because I knew that I knew that I would favor them, so that you know, I knew that I would get a fair share of this color in the mix. I do like that. Just like that. I think what I'm going to do here is say that this goes, wait, this isn't the right green. It's like you need to have like five different things. This green, I think, is the green that I want to get in the mix here. You know what I mean? Because this is a yellow, and this is more of a you know, the thing is that I really love to be able to listen to music while I do this, but when I'm doing it for live stream, I'm concerned about copyright infringement from the music that I'm listening to. You know. And you got some little watercolory doodads. That is, okay. I have this rag that has so many spots on it from all the different paint, from all the dabbing that I've done over the years. The dabs that I've done, you know, the dabs that I'm doing now. Ooh, that's kind of cool. I like that. Yeah, you know, the thing is, I always save it, man. I always save it. It'll, you know, that's the, that is the age-old fear, I guess, that, you know, shit's not gonna work out. And, like, that's all bullshit. It always works out. Look at that. Just, like, fucking banging it up. Bang, bang, bang. Yeah, all of these, you know, require... something, right? Even this needs something here. This. You need to say, hey. What else we got going on? That's yellow here, I think here. It's kind of cool. I'm actually looking at this through the other eye in the sky. Actually, I have it on. Damn, where's that one? Oh, this one. There's this, but then there's another. I feel like there's another wild orange, or this is not it. Here we go. More of an orangey, because like, I'm seeing this here, and it's like, that's the vibe I'm getting from this now. Like, more, get a little more orange into the mix there. Yeah, definitely feeling more right. And this is just some other thing that I think I'm going to go back to this guy and just say, hey, you know what? I'm pulling blues into everything. And it's working, so why fuck with it? Almost like, you know, you put a little blue in there just to fuck with it. But I'm very pleased with that line, and then this is gonna be a little bit more blue, of course. It's like a hippopotamus zoo. Oh, that's cool. Not the first time I had colored pencils in my hand. So, you know. Right. She's finally coming together, man. To throw everything back in here when I'm not using it. This is my so one thing at a time. Yeah. So you gotta like not OD on it. But the orange that I'm feeling it's got to... Right? How's that feel? It's a little bit better, right? Why do I gotta do that? It's like, well, it's like, it's like you could, but why not get it? Okay, so where is the fucking one that's obviously supposed to be red? Tell me that came in the fucking only in the 24 pack. I'm pissed. So I'm guessing this is crimson. Okay, so this is crimson. This is the actual red. Yeah, you know, you just gotta like keep fucking with it. I mean, this is definitely a piece, if I fuck up, worth saving, and quite possibly not hard to save. I tend to like to hold the things in my hand because then I'm like, all right, well, what the fuck do I got here? And am I dealing on, here's black, because this motherfucker's got to get dark here. Saying Okay, so this is a pharmacological blue. I mean, I have no idea if you're supposed to draw on these while it's wet or paint on them after they're done, but I figure. Definitely gives like a really cool painterly, so that's more of that, but then this is more of a green here. Right. Like, there is this other green here that I feel should be addressed. You know, there's this green. To all possibilities. Sometimes you find yourself in a situation that could be good. I mean, takes some time. You gotta look at it then say, what am I doing here? Definitely want to retain certain parts. blue everything. Blue, blue, blue. I mean, I don't know who's gonna wanna like have this on their wall necessarily, but isn't that neat how it just kind of like you get that and that and that, you know, kind of sets the tone of like, okay, well, what's the darkest dark there is. You know, how dark does it need to be? I mean, to be honest, folks, I am getting hungry. How long are we at? Yes. This one is very cool, you know, that dude's little face. what I should do is have it be this dark. And you're like, oh wow, should I do that too here? Maybe. But I also happen to think that really see where black really pops it out more when you're trying to, you know, pull these geometrics. Ooh, look at that. That was a mistake, but a very happy, pleasurable mistake that I like there. Forgot about this color too. Yeah, dude, why did I forget this in the first place, huh? What did I do to forget this? Why did you make me forget this? And that's gonna carry this all through the mix. Gonna use this, or try to use this.
I made this eraser myself because it was,
it was too big for the attachment on the end. So, like, I mean, I'm just using this pencil as an eraser anyway, because of the back end. It has, like, a really great long eraser, which is great for certain sized areas, especially if you're on the go. But if you want that, like, really topical blend situation, hold on, that can be.
Yes. Get the Yes. Yes, the only drawback to this is that I cannot communicate while I am doing this. So, to the chat anyway. Here we go. This is going on there. Isn't that neat? I have had this mug, by the way, this mug here, you can probably see that there's a lot of paint on this. Well, I have had this mug since I was in college. I don't know who gave it to me. If it was my, you know, mom or aunt, but or grandmother, but this has been. I've used this cup for my water cup for a lot of years. So shout out to the water cups. Right? The lift and repeat method give it so much dimension. Giving it a bit to a week, you know what I want away. And I am already gone away. And I say this is the dawning of a Juliet, time and time again. Time and time again. Yep. Figures, it's in my hand. All right, so overdoer's regret. I sometimes have a little bit of remorse over how deep I go. So, like, luckily this is not a bad situation, because truthfully it's supposed to be a little bit of contrast there. I just didn't know that that's what that was going to be, so maybe we just do that. You know what I mean? Because and then this motherfucker is like the looking pretty cool. Definitely want to choose a point in time in which to stop. This looks like a good time. Been going about how many minutes here? Looks pretty good, right? Yeah, so I just can't go too heavy on this dark stuff, but I like how the left side, pops out more, and this sort of like falls back behind it, which is sort of the idea I wanted to have, which I did do. So I think the next idea is
this sort of like falls back.
Yeah, I was trying to basically see how long I've been doing this, but hard to see. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I will be doing more, or you probably see me do more. I just need to get something to eat. So thanks for watching, guys.